Christian Business Connection, connecting your business or ministry to the world.
Good morning, and welcome to the CBC Christian Business Connection radio show. I'm your host, Evangelist Nona Thomas. Here I go. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice, glory, hallelujah, and be glad in it. Oh, I give him the praise today. God is greatly to be praised. Yes, he is. I hope you feel that way this morning. I hope that you are rejuvenated, that there is a fresh wind blowing through your hair. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And you know, friends, I gotta say right off the top that I use that expression because this past weekend, we have had a wonderful time at the Fresh Wind of Glory Women's Retreat. Glory to God. I tell you, Apostle Keita Lattimore, so grateful to God that he put the vision for the women's retreat in her heart and she was obedient. It was a great blessing. Well done, Apostle Keita Lattimore. Hallelujah. Friends, I also want to say a special good morning to everyone who listens to the CBC radio show on the internet. Glory to God. Thank you for listening all around the world. You are a great blessing. Keep on praying for me. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Also want to say a special good morning to Mr. Eddie Randall of Randall and Sons Funeral Home. Great work they're doing right there in Midtown in St. Louis, Missouri, right there on Natural Bridge. I encourage you, go to my website, thecbcradioshow.com, so that you can get more information about Eddie Randall and Sons. Truly, truly a wonderful place in your time of need. All right. Now, this morning's show, we have a great show as usual. You know I say that, but it is the truth. It's always power-packed. We always have wonderful people who are a part of the Christian Business Connection. You know, during this month of April, we have our author of the month who we're featuring, and I'm so excited about that. And you're going to hear in just a bit about who we are featuring and promoting in the month of April. So, friends, let me tell you, if you want to be a part of the CBC radio show, if you would like to advertise your business, your ministry, or your upcoming event, give me a call at 314-270-2225. That's 314-270-2225. And I also encourage you to listen to my Wednesday program that comes on right here on Hallelujah 1600 at 4 p.m. to 4:15. It is the midweek message with Evangelist Nona Thomas, and it is a blessing. It's simply speaking God's word, speaking into your life. I have guest hosts who are part of the program. I'm telling you, it's definitely something to encourage you in the midweek, all right? Anytime, anytime. Well, let's get to my guest this morning. You know, we are preparing for the upcoming Holy Convocation at the end of the month that is going to be hosted by Apostle William H. Bingham and Pastor Ella Bingham of Perpetual Life Church. Well, this morning we're going to be talking with one of the speakers, Pastor Charles Jones. So you got to stay tuned. We're going to have a great, great, great time talking about the Lord and what's going to happen with the upcoming Holy Convocation. We're also talking this morning with Pastor Keith Scarborough, who is the pastor of Word at Shaw. The Word at Shaw. Great work that is going on over in South Saint. So you're really going to be encouraged by hearing from Pastor Keith this morning. And then we're going to be talking with Dr. Gloria Johnson. As I said, she is the Christian Business Connection author of the month. Her fantastic book is I Cried Alone. I'm telling you, you're going to get some wonderful inspirational stories of women who have overcome, who are survivors of abuse. The book is wonderful, you all. That's all I can tell you. You're going to hear Dr. Johnson expand on the book today and throughout this month. And then we're going to be talking with Ms. Veronica Williams. You know, here we are in springtime and there's some spring cleaning that has got to be done. So we're going to talk with her this morning. So you don't want to miss that as well. Well, friends, I'm going to take a short break. You're going to hear some great commercials, you know, because we got to have commercial time now. All right. And when we come back, I'm going to be talking with Apostle William H. Bingham and Pastor Ella Bingham and Pastor Charles Jones. Don't miss it. I'll be right back. Hi, this is Evangelist Nona Thomas, inviting you to tune in to Hallelujah 1600 at 4 p.m. every Wednesday for the midweek message. Friends, let me tell you, this program will encourage you. It will inspire you. It will be the boost that will be right on time in the Word of God for your Wednesday afternoon. So tune in every Wednesday, 4 p.m., right here on Hallelujah 1600 for the midweek message with Evangelist Nona Thomas. To God be the glory.
Good morning, St. Louis and metropolitan area. This is Pastor Ella Marie Bingham from the Perpetual Life Church, 1400 Park Avenue, St. Louis, Missouri, 63104. I just want to invite you out to the Kingdom Minded for Kingdom Living Holy Convocation, which will be held April 27th through May 1st. We have many teachers, preachers that's going to come and bring the Word of God. We want to see you there. It starts promptly 7 p.m. each night. And guess what? We have daytime classes here starting at 9 o'clock in the morning till 1 from all the way from Arkansas, Florida. We're just going to have a good time in the Lord. See you there.
Hi, this is Michael McMillan, President and CEO of the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis. Glad to be here with Evangelist Nona Thomas on the Christian Business Connection radio show.
Welcome back to the CBC radio show. I'm your host, Evangelist Nona Thomas, and I'm so excited about this next interview. Friends, we have been talking about the upcoming Kingdom Minded for Kingdom Living Holy Convocation scheduled for April 27th through May 1st. I tell you, the Lord is going to do some great, great, great things. And we're so blessed to have in the studio with us today none other than the host of this phenomenal event, and one of the guest speakers is going to be there. I have with me this morning Apostle William Bingham and Pastor Ella Bingham of Perpetual Life Church. And also we have this morning Pastor Charles Jones, who will be the speaker on Sunday morning and also on Friday in the morning time of Antioch Baptist Church. So good morning and welcome, everyone.
Good morning, Evangelist Thomas.
You know, I think that Apostle Bingham and Pastor Bingham know the answer that I'm going to ask to this question. And I know you do too, Pastor Jones, so I'm going to give it to you. Is that all right?
That's okay.
I didn't prep you, but it's easy. And the question is this the day that the Lord has made for you?
Yes, it has. And I'm rejoicing and being, I'm glad in it.
You get an A+, sir. That's all right.
He sure got
That's
it.
All right. Apostle Bingham, we are so excited about this upcoming Holy Convocation. Can you just put it to us and tell us what the Lord is going to do?
Evangelist Thomas, I am so excited what God is doing in the city of St. Louis. And as you have stated, we got our guests all the way from Oviedo, Florida, Pastor Charles Jones from Antioch. And Pastor, I think you told me you guys are celebrating your 184 years?
41st.
Uh-huh. Wow. Yes. Now he's going to be speaking for us, and I'm excited. He has a word, a rhema word from the Lord. He's going to minister before us that Friday morning, and also that Sunday he's going to close us out with his male chorus. And, oh, I tell you, you're talking about some singing, man. But I thank God for the preached word that's going to come from him. And so, Evangelist Thomas, I'm excited what God is getting ready to do this year, 2016.
Yes, it is going to be a great blessing. You know, Pastor Jones, I believe for you to come this far, all the way from Florida, that the Lord has truly put a message in your belly. Am I right about that?
Yes, he has. Yes, he has.
So can you give us a little taste of it, Pastor Jones? Tell us everything.
Yes.
Tell us everything.
Yes.
Just give us a little bit.
Yes, one of the things that our talk of Pastor Mr. Bingham-Berry is about kingdom-minded for kingdom living. And I found out, and he was talking about getting people to get out of comfort zones, and I found out that one of the hardest things for a leader is getting people to leave an environment that requires a sacrifice on their part. Mm-hmm. And so one of the biggest sacrifices many people is getting them to move from a particular way of thinking, because you know that you can't get people to do anything if, first of all, they got to start first in their mind.
Amen. That's it.
And so even God himself made an appeal to the people of mine, and you know, the scripture where it says, come now, let us reason together. See, if you can't get anybody to start thinking a new way, you're not going to get them to do anything new. And I always use this phrase: if you do this, if you always do what you've always done, you'll always be what you've always been.
Mm.
So you have to get people to think about that. So I'm excited to come up and share some things God has shared with me here about getting people to move from an old mindset to a kingdom mindset.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I think that's good news this morning, Pastor Gerald. Don't you think that's good news this morning?
That is absolutely great.
Yes, I do. And I'm just excited about Pastor Jones and Antioch being with us and the mail course and be able to meet new people and new friends. And that's what the Lord would have us to do, to spread this love all around. Sometimes we always say, Evangelist Nona, this is 2016, the year of love. Mm-hmm. And so we're learning now that we need to love one another. Mm-hmm. Not only love one another, we're in this kingdom minded for kingdom living. Mm-hmm. And God is getting us ready because we are kingdom citizens.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, and as Pastor Jones was saying, we have to get a new mindset.
Yeah.
If you're going to be a kingdom citizen, you got to get ready to go to the kingdom. Amen.
That's right. I know you feel that way.
Oh my God. We're getting ready for, the king is getting ready to make his return.
Amen.
And so as God is beginning to show us things, the enemy is escalating his attack upon the body of Christ as well as the church.
That's right.
And so we have to get our mindset, as Pastor stated, our minds ready for the kingdom of God,
Amen.
Which is going to begin right here with us.
Amen.
And so we thank God for the anointed speakers that's going to come and destroy some of that old thinking, that old man. And once again, we can't continue to feed that new man that's in us, that old man stuff.
Yeah, that's good. You know, Pastor Jones, the message that you're bringing here to St. Louis from Florida, is that also a message that you're teaching at your church?
I have. You know, we did a building project here, and more often, we've had to deal with that issue to get people to in a building program now, and we just built a new building here. So we had to do that. Can I share this, though?
Sure.
In order to get people to move, there always has to be, they have to become dissatisfied with where they are.
Right.
All right, so you'll never get a person move from where they are until they become dissatisfied. And, you know, and what God does, more often than not, what he does, God often gives people or cause some discomfort in order to get them to see where they are is they were not satisfied with being there any longer. So both Moses and Joshua had a hard time getting the Israelites to follow them where God was leading them, but God caused discomfort there in Egypt so they could get out there and said, listen, we got to get out of here. So mm-hmm. anyway, in every true move of God often come in conflict with what people think.
Mm-hmm.
It always challenges natural tendencies, and it always makes us feel uncomfortable.
Yeah. Amen. Yeah. You're right about that.
Every true move of God.
Yes, yeah. You're right about that. I want to let my listeners know, if you're just tuning in this morning, we're talking with Apostle William Bingham, Pastor Ella Bingham, and Pastor Charles Jones of Antioch Baptist Church. Now, we're talking about the kingdom minded for kingdom living holy convocation coming up on April 27th through May 1st. Now that's going to be at Perpetual Life Church, located at 1400 Park Avenue, 63104, 7 p.m. nightly. And I want to say that all of these sessions are free. Am I right, Apostle?
You
Megan?
Are correct. Amen.
Amen.
There is no admission. There is no registration fees. We just want you to come out and enjoy what God is speaking to his people
Amen.
In these end times that we're living in.
That's it. And I want to personally endorse it because I was there last year for the first time. And I tell you, the revelation and the knowledge that was downloaded into the people that we really didn't want to leave. I remember one of those nights, we were there almost till midnight. And that was all right. Wasn't nobody complaining about it because the Holy Ghost was speaking.
Amen.
Am I right, Pastor?
That's right. That's right. The Spirit of the Lord is moving in this end time. He is getting us ready for that kingdom. So therefore, we need to learn and to glean from one another and allow the Holy Spirit to have his way so that he can get us ready for this end season. And I am so glad, as we were talking with Pastor Jones, that God has given him a rhema word for this season. Amen. And that's what we have to do in this season, to be ready to hear from the Lord. In other words, we need some fresh bread.
Yes.
You know, the bread is all right, but when you get some fresh bread, when you hear from the Lord, you know, that's what it's all about, is getting that rhema, that fresh bread.
Yes, it is. Pastor Jones, you're going to bring several loaves with you.
Yes,
because we need all that. We need it to be smoking hot, okay?
I am excited to be in St. Louis again. I always enjoy coming up there. I got some friends over in Florissant.
Amen.
Florence and we're just excited to come to that part of St. Louis this time. So we are looking forward to being up there and sharing the word, and also to be blessed.
Amen.
And hearing other speakers as well.
Amen.
Amen. Apostle Bingham, we're just about out of time. I want you to close us out. Is there anything else you'd like to say in closing, sir?
Pastor, and to all of our listeners in the St. Louis area, we're getting ready for this convocation this year that's going to be like none other. We've been doing this now for 7 years, but God impressed upon my heart that the number seven is the year of perfection.
Wow.
So it's going to be off the chain, as we say.
Yeah.
And so we thank God for all of our speakers starting Wednesday through Sunday morning, looking forward to seeing. And I've heard Pastor preach, and he is a preaching machine.
Uh-oh.
And so we thank God for him, and he's going to be with us, along with several other speakers from out of town. And our Covenant Churches are going to be with us that week. So, Evangelist Thomas, I am just excited. As we say, I'm elated, amen, for what God is getting ready to do.
Indeed. God. Just in case there's somebody who wants to call for more information, what phone number can they reach the church at, Apostle Bingham?
Area code 314-588-9921. Repeat, area code 314-588-9921.
Wonderful. And then, of course, you can go to the cbcradioshow.com website, where we will have information about the Holy Convocation as well. Thank you, all of my guests. Pastor Jones, thank you so much for tuning in with us this morning. We appreciate you, sir.
God bless you. Thank you for having us on. Okay.
We're going to take a short break right here. Stay with me. I'll be right back. Hi, this is Evangelist Nona Thomas, inviting you to tune in to Hallelujah 1600 at 4 p.m. every Wednesday for the midweek message. Friends, let me tell you, this program will encourage you. It will inspire you. It will be the boost that will be right on time in the Word of God for your Wednesday afternoon. So tune in every Wednesday, 4 p.m., right here on Hallelujah 1600 for the midweek message with Evangelist Nona Thomas. To God be the glory. Welcome back to the CBC Radio Show. I'm your host, Evangelist Nona Thomas. And friends, I told you at the top of the program, I was so excited this morning because we're going to be speaking with Pastor Keith Scarborough, the pastor of the Word at Shaw. I'm so excited about the things that we're going to talk about this morning that I believe are going to be a blessing to you. So I want to welcome to the CBC Radio Show, Pastor Keith. Good morning.
Good morning. It's great to be here. Thanks for inviting me.
Oh, you're welcome. Now, Pastor, I didn't prep you on this question. It's something that I ask everybody who comes on the show. And that is this the day that the Lord has made for you?
Oh, man. God is doing great things in our city. And I'm just so happy that God has allowed me to be a part of it. And so every morning I wake up with just this awe and wonder of, you know, God, look what you're doing, and thanks for letting me have a front row seat to get to watch what's going on.
Amen. That's a good answer, Pastor. I tell you, you know, I often say that it's just so amazing that he uses decorated dust like us.
That's great. That's exactly right.
Well, Pastor, God is doing some amazing things through your ministry at the church. What I love about the Word at Shaw, you have an expression on your printed materials that you say it's a different kind of church. Tell us why, Pastor.
Well, we don't do things like most any other place does, and I think more that may be more a reflection of the people who live in our community than anything else. But we kind of came to be, St. Louis, and to look like the people who are walking around us.
Mm-hmm.
And so, Dr. King said that the most segregated hour in America was 11 a.m., on Sunday morning. And our Sunday morning is extremely diverse. Mm-hmm. As you know, our staff is both African-American and white, and our congregation is about 50-50. Mm-hmm. And so that's an unusual place just to begin with. Mm-hmm. But then on top of that, you know, I don't wear robes. I don't whenever I wear a tie, I get criticized openly. And, you know, we don't do things that are ritualistic. It's a fun and casual place. And it's just a place where we can celebrate what God is doing in our lives and through our lives and into our community.
Well, I do have to amen that, Pastor, because my first time coming to the church, you really could just feel just a spirit of peace and love. I mean, it was really greeting you as you walked in the door, and only God can do that. Isn't that right?
That's right. That's exactly right. That's exactly right.
Yeah. Tell us about the service times for the different things you have at the church, Pastor.
Yeah. Well, we start our service in the worship center at 11 a.m., but we open before that. You know, Evangelist, when we set out to do something in a multicultural way, then we recognized instantly that we needed to create environments that would allow people just to sit and talk. Mm-hmm. You know, we do very little talk about race relations. We always just say, let's get closer to Jesus. The closer we get to Jesus, the closer we'll be to each other. Mm-hmm. And part of that breaks down into, you know, environments that allow people to have holy conversations. Mm-hmm. And we invite people to come early. We have a coffee house. Here, we actually, when we planted the church, this is our fifth March, mm-hmm. and so when we planted the church, we actually moved into an old United Methodist building, and so one of the first things that we did after we finished the sanctuary was we ripped out three classrooms and created a coffee house, because we believe that coffee house environments are better than classrooms, at least for the neighborhood that we're trying to connect to. Mm-hmm. And so we open up our coffee house, and people come in, they check their emails, they sit around and drink Hartford Coffee Company coffee, and just kind of relax into the morning, and that opens at 10:30. So we spend a good 30 minutes before, you know, kind of getting caffeined up before we go in and work.
Well, Pastor, I'm so glad you mentioned the coffee house at Shaw, because that was my introduction to the church, to the ministry, and I'm so excited to be a part of what God is doing with the coffee house and bringing new business and bringing, you know, people to be aware of the coffee house at Shaw.
Yeah, it's a great place. It's turned out to be more than a Sunday morning a place where people can gather. We do things for the community here all the time. We have an AA meeting that meets every Wednesday night here, and it's a great group. More than 50 people, usually, you know, more like 100 folks gather there, and it's open to our community. But beyond that, we have community parties like seed exchanges and holiday dances there, and then you know, we in the midst of all of the trials that our city has been going through, we've been hosting what we're just calling the conversation, and it's just neighbors mm-hmm. coming in. Mm-hmm. And so most of the people who come to those, and we've had up to 100 of those, I think we've done 8 of them already. Most of the people who come there do not attend the church. A good faction do, but most of them don't. Mm-hmm. But we wanted to be open to the community and be doing things for, you know, for our community, a place where people can gather and meet each other, because we find that is that's a value of ours. And so last Friday we hosted a spoken word night, and I know you were there, but mm-hmm. That was with our friends with Faith Communities, mm-hmm. and it was a fundraiser for our for AIDS community. Mm-hmm. And then I know we have a comedy night coming. I'm really excited about that.
Yes.
You're bringing that in, and then some other jazz nights, and just ways that people can come together and good, clean entertainment,
yes.
spend the time together, and you know, it doesn't. This is not meant to insult. It just doesn't feel like church, you know. It's a really nice, kind of vibey place where
yes.
people can connect. And, you know, Jesus acted in those places all the time, more
yes.
than in church setting.
Yes.
And so that's where we feel like he's still working that way here.
Yes, he is. is. Well, I want to let my listeners know that if you're just tuning in this morning, we're talking with Pastor Keith Scarborough, the pastor at the Word at Shaw Church. Now, Pastor, I know folks are listening and they're like, well, how can we get connected? Tell us how we can get connected to the Word at Shaw.
Right. First off, our website's fairly easy. It's the name of our church, The Word at Shaw. Mm-hmm. Everything's spelled out, smooshed mm-hmm. together. Mm-hmm. That's a .org address. And all of our events, all of our calendar, everything that we do there is there. We have by the way, we're located right across the street from the Botanical Garden. Most people know where we're at. Mm-hmm. We're on the corner of Tower Grove and Shaw. That's the reason why, for the name. But right across from the Missouri Botanical Garden. We have mission projects all the time. We actually run a furniture showroom store. It's for the Shalom House, which is a homeless shelter just about a mile away from our location here for ladies. And so ladies go through their program. By the way, they have a 97% success rate. When they go through Shalom House, they are no longer homeless. Our little church in only 4 years has helped 45 ladies leave the shelter, come off the street, into the shelter, off the shelter, out of the shelter, into their own furnished apartment. And we're the folks who do the furnishings. And so we collect furniture, clean furniture, repair furniture, pack furniture, load furniture, and then set up apartments for them. And so you can help with that. You can help us with our work with Shalom House. On Thursdays, we have a program we call SNAP, which is an after-school Shaw neighborhood after-school program for kids under 16, 10 to 16 years old. And there's plenty of opportunities to serve there. And then, of course, on Sunday morning, just come. And, you know, we say some people like to come and jump in and become members and, like, you know, start to serve and do all those things. But we also leave plenty of room just to sit and listen. Just mm-hmm. come in and kind of check it out. And, you know, Jesus always said, come and see, come and see, come and see. Mm-hmm. And so we leave plenty of room for that. So, you know, if you or friends of yours don't have a church and are a little skeptical of church, that's kind of who we want to meet. We want to meet people like that so they can come in, relax, see the environment, and then start to be filled with the Spirit of God.
Well, I definitely felt like I was at home. I felt like I've already been grafted in, and you're going to look up, Pastor, and see me walking through the door just to come and sup with you every that's now good. And then. Would that be all right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I'm looking forward to it.
Wonderful. Well, Pastor, we're just about out of time. And give us the address again sure. for the Word at Shaw.
Sure. It's 4265 Shaw. And it's on the corner of Tower Grove and Shaw, right across from the Missouri Botanical Garden. And it's an older United Methodist Church building, but when you step inside, you'll see what all our volunteers have been doing to refurbish it and make it all brand new.
Amen. Is there anything else that you'd like to say in closing, Pastor Keith?
Hey, I just love to say God bless you to everybody who is listening. God is doing great things. And God, our God, the God we serve, is one who can take horrible things, such as the things we're going through right now, and turn them into good. And I know that's going to happen for our city. And as I've said, I'm so thrilled that God has allowed us to be a part of it and have a front row seat to watch how he's at work in our city.
Amen. Me too, Pastor. Bless you. You are a joy, Pastor Keith. Thank you so much for being a part of the CBC radio show today.
God bless you.
All righty. Friends, we're going to take a short break right here. Stay with me. I'll be right back. Hi, this is Evangelist Nona Thomas, inviting you to tune in to Hallelujah 1600 at 4 p.m. every Wednesday for the midweek message. Friends, let me tell you, this program will encourage you. It will inspire you. It will be the boost that will be right on time in the Word of God for your Wednesday afternoon. So tune in every Wednesday, 4 p.m., right here on Hallelujah 1600 for the midweek message with Evangelist Nona Thomas. To God be the glory.
Good morning, St. Louis and metropolitan area. This is Pastor Ella Marie Bingham from the Perpetual Life Church, 1400 Park Avenue, St. Louis, Missouri, 63104. I just want to invite you out to the Kingdom Minded for Kingdom Living Holy Convocation, which will be held April 27th through May
first. We have many teachers, preachers that's going to come and bring the word of God. We want to see you there. It starts promptly 7 p.m. each night. And guess what? We have daytime classes here starting at 9 o'clock in the morning till 1 from all the way from Arkansas, Florida. We're just going to have a good time in the Lord. See you there.
Welcome back to the CBC Radio Show. I'm your host, Evangelist Nona Thomas. And friends, I told you at the top of the program that we are so excited in this month of April because we are featuring the phenomenal book, the wonderful book by Dr. Gloria Johnson. She's our author of the month of I Cried Alone. And we're so blessed to have in the studio with us today the executive assistant of Dr. Gloria Johnson, Ms. Michelle Johnson. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm wonderful. Now, you know, I didn't prep you on this question, but that is this the day that the Lord has made for you?
Yes, it is. Every day.
Every day. You
every
enjoy
day.
It?
Always.
And you're glad in it.
Amen.
All right. All right. Well, I know that you're glad. We're so excited about this powerful book that Dr. Johnson wrote entitled I Cried Alone. And, you know, you have been there from the conception of the book, in addition to Life Source Consultants, in which Dr. Johnson is the founder. And, you know, I don't know which one I want to get to first, the book or Life Source Consultants. You know, not only as the executive assistant to Dr. Johnson, you're her granddaughter. So you have firsthand in the building of what God has done, don't you?
I do. I've been around since I was 4 years old. That was when they opened, and I've learned a lot, and I feel like it's definitely made me a better person to have my grandmother that I've been blessed with.
Yes, yes, yes. Tell us about Life Consultants. Give us a little foundation on Life Source Consultants before we get to the book.
It's a place that is a safe haven for anyone who's experiencing violence in their life, mm-hmm. whether it's a young person, an old person, a wife. We don't deal with men, but we do have things to help men.
Sure.
And it's somewhere you can go when you don't know what to do.
Mm-hmm. You know, and as you were saying, safe haven, I also think about that phrase. It's a safe place to land. It's confidential, isn't it?
Yes, it's confidential. If you do need help and it's an emergency, there's things that are put in place to protect you and make sure that you are okay. You are the number one priority.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You know, if we had statistics in front of us, I'm sure we would see that there is a rise in domestic violence against women. We don't have those statistics, but I'm sure it's increased, hasn't it? It's increasing.
I mean, I feel like these days everything's increasing.
Isn't it
the truth? Little bit crazy out there.
Yeah.
But, you know, hopefully people find things to help them so that the numbers will decrease.
Mm-hmm,
so
mm-hmm.
We want everybody to be safe. Mm-hmm. We don't want anybody to be living in a dangerous situation.
That's right. That's right. From the, I guess the foundation of the book is from the life experiences of women who have gone through abuse, who've gone through situations. And the book is a compilation of those experiences. And really, it's a book of hope, isn't it?
The book is kind of a how-to guide to domestic violence, whether you are a victim, whether you know someone, whether you've gone through things and never dealt with them, a parent of a child who's in a bad relationship, mm-hmm. all of it. There's mm-hmm. something for everybody.
Yes, yes. I'm glad you said that part because the children, you know, they're looking on, they're seeing this violence that may be done to their mother, you know, or their loved one. And that can be just as traumatic, can it?
It definitely can. And I think there's things that show that children that grow up in violent homes tend to be more violent.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that
I can imagine every situation possible being on the inside and talking with and perhaps even counseling these women. Am I right about that?
I have. And, you know, even though I've seen a lot of kids that come in with their mom who may have been in a violent situation. I do still see that they're still a happy kid. You know, for the most part, their innocence remains intact.
Yes.
And I can appreciate that.
Indeed. You know, one of the chapters in the book, I Cried Alone by Dr. Gloria Johnson, she talks about teen dating. She talks about, you know, that whole situation. And I know there were some things that were on your heart that you wanted to talk about as well in regards to that chapter. So go right ahead.
I mean, I definitely believe that right now young people are in a hyper-sexualized, hyper-connected, everything's on public display. And your likes equal how good your relationship is. All of that. There's too much sharing. There's too much everything. And I feel like the thing that I've noticed the most is young people don't know how to be in a healthy relationship. They want to be in a relationship because that's what they see everywhere. You look on TV and everybody's in love and oh, it looks so good and you want it, but they don't know how to love themselves or each other. And it's just toxic.
Yes, yes. You know, we can pause right there. They perhaps don't know how to love themselves, because you got to love yourself. How can you love someone else and you don't love or even like yourself, right?
Exactly. I know a lot of people, well, not a lot of people, but I do know a few people that it seems to me like they're looking for something to fill a hole in themselves that they don't know they need to fill with themselves instead of with another person.
My Lord, now you've said something right there, because that's a lot of pressure to put on somebody else to fulfill you and to make you feel however that void is. That's a lot of pressure on somebody, and it just can't be done.
And I feel like when I look at these, there's a lot of young people that, like, they're so controlling to the other person. Like the other day, I heard these two 18-year-olds having a conversation, and it was, would you be willing to spend a few days apart? And I was like, I know married people that don't spend as much time together as you two do, and it's not healthy. I'm like, what are you going to do when you're a grown up and you want to get married and you have to have a job and you have to have kids and you have to go? You can't just sit on top of each other for the rest of forever and it's going to be happily ever after.
You know, and so some of the things that the assistants through Life Source Consultants, I would think when people come and or when the women come, there are resources to help them in those relationships, isn't it? There's counseling to help them establish healthy relationships or get out of the bad one.
Yes. Everybody at Life Source they're very nice and they're very understanding. They understand where everyone is coming from and they get it.
Yeah.
They get your heart being in love or your head feeling a different way. They get everything. They know where you're coming from and they want to help you no matter what. You can go in there and cry. You can lay on the floor and cry. We will cry with you. It is okay. Like, we just want you to be okay.
Yes, yes, yes. Well, I want to let my listeners know, if you're just tuning in this morning, we're talking with Michelle A. Johnson, who is the executive assistant to Dr. Gloria Johnson, who is our author of the month, featuring her wonderful book, I Cried Alone. Michelle A., I want to get to the contact information, because we may have somebody who is listening right now and they know of someone who may be in an abusive relationship, or they may be experiencing something. Can you tell us how people can get in contact with Life Source Consultants and also to get a copy of this exciting book?
They can call us at our county office, which is in Ferguson. The number is 314-524-4130. And if you are somewhere else that's not in Ferguson or in the county, we can help you find somewhere that's closer to you. Also, to get a copy of the book, you can send an email to Dr. Gloria Johnson. Oh, no, I'm sorry. And the email address to get the book is GloriaJohnsonPhD@yahoo.com.
Give us the phone number one more time, would you?
It's 314-524-4130.
Wonderful, wonderful. You know, what I appreciate about Life Source Consultants is that sometimes folks just need to talk to somebody. They need to talk to someone who is outside of the circle, or perhaps they feel like, you know, I can't, for whatever reason, they can't talk to their relative or their loved one, or they're afraid, and they can talk with someone who doesn't, who's, you know, who's impartial to their life, and they can just talk direct to them. Am I saying that right?
Yes, they're not only are they impartial, like I said, they are there for you.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever you need, we will try our hardest to help you mm-hmm. acquire whatever that is.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter. You, like I said, you need a shoulder to cry on.
Mm-hmm.
We're there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You need some food for your kids, maybe. We can help you find that. We can help you find a lot of things. But if you suffer in silence, no one can help you.
Mm. If you suffer in silence, which takes me back to the title of the book, I Cried Alone, because there are so many who may think that there's no help, that, you know, I'm just stuck in this situation. And as a young woman, you know, I'm sure that teen dating, that whole area of the book, you can definitely relate to, because you're looking at your peers. You know, you've got a heartbeat as to what may be going on in your generation. Am I right?
I definitely see things that I've been raised as red flags
mm-hmm.
in a lot of young people's relationships. And I just said the other day, they should teach in high school how to be in a healthy relationship and maybe how to file your taxes too.
A two for one.
Yeah. But definitely, because there's keys that come with being in an adult relationship and being able to be with someone and let them be there for you that you might not necessarily know if you just jump in.
Right.
And dive in head first and end up like, whoa, hold on. Right. How did I get here?
Right.
I'm 19. I got three kids and he left. Like, it gets hard. Kids think it's so easy to be an adult and it's, I want to hurry up and grow up. But realistically, it's like, being an adult is kind of the hardest thing ever.
Yes, that's a whole other show. Yes. You know, how blessed you have been to have a grandmother as Dr. Gloria Johnson, because you've seen a couple things. Number one, she took this vision that the Lord gave her and has turned it into, words can't even describe how many women she has helped in her organization. And it's been a learning and a training tool for you, hasn't it?
It definitely has shaped the way that I feel my life is supposed to be.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like I know things that other people don't know only because my grandmother is who she is. So I feel like I always try to help and give a word of advice that maybe someone hasn't heard before, because sure, they were raised in a home where your dad hits your mom and that's okay.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So mm-hmm. I just always think about, you know, what would my grandma say? What would she do?
That's right.
Kind of gets me through.
Yeah, yeah. Truly, you've really been blessed. I mean, one thing I wanted to touch on about the book is the stories that were compiled, that Dr. Johnson put together. They're from really every aspect you can think of. I mean, it is so well-rounded, from a situation that it may be, you know, severe, to not just the physical abuse, but the mental and the verbal abuse, because sometimes people don't think about that. They think, oh, well, you know, he just talks bad to me because he gets upset, or, you know, but verbal abuse can be just as traumatic. Am I right?
It definitely can be. I have a friend, and I feel like the way that her and her husband speak to each other, it kind of takes me back sometimes. I'll be sitting there, I'm like, that's how you guys talk to each other? You're mm-hmm. married. You're supposed to love each other.
Mm-hmm.
But they both do it. And I'm like, I guess that's how you interpret love.
Hmm. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I right, the interpretations of love, that's a whole other show. But what I think is so important about this book is that it is definitely a path to show what not to be on. Okay, what
definitely
path to not be on. And it encourages you, and I believe it strengthens you to come out of the situation, don't you think?
I think that maybe there's people who don't know. Like I said, if you interpret love a certain way and you don't know that it's not good for you, and you get your hands on this book, you might say, you know what? This is, you've been abusing me.
Right.
And it's not okay. And we have to do something about it.
It's not okay. In any fashion, it's not okay. Well, Michelle, you are special. You're blessed that the Lord, isn't it amazing? You didn't have any knowledge of where you would be born and who you would be born to and who would be in your family, as none of us do. And I know you're so grateful to be a part of what God has built through Dr. Gloria Johnson.
I definitely am.
Give us the contact information, how people can get the book, I Cried Alone, and also for Life Source Consultants.
To get the book, email GloriaJohnsonPhD@yahoo.com. And for anything that is violence related, call Life Source Consultants at 314-524-4130.
One more time with that number.
314-524-4130.
Well, it has been a joy to have you a part of the CBC radio show today. Thank you for being here.
Thank you very much for having me.
All right, friends, we're going to take a short break right here. Stay with me. I'll be right back.
Hi, this is Michael McMillan, President and CEO of the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis. Glad to be here with evangelist Nona Thomas on the Christian Business Connection radio show.
Welcome back to the CBC Radio Show. I'm your host, Evangelist Nona Thomas. And friends, I'm so excited. You know, this month of April, we are needing to do some spring cleaning, all right? I'm going to talk about spring cleaning in the natural, but I believe also there's some spring cleaning that needs to be done in the supernatural as well. We're going to get back to that, but I'm so excited to have on the program with me this morning an expert in that area. We're going to be talking with Ms. Veronica Williams of Williams International, doing business as Simply Essentially Clean. Oh, I love it. I love it. So I want to welcome to the CBC radio show, Ms. Veronica Williams. Good morning.
Good morning.
Now, you know, I got to ask you this question, and you might know the answer to it. I hope you know the answer to it. It's real easy. And that question is this the day that the Lord has made for you?
It is. And let us all be glad in it.
Yes. You rejoicing too?
I am rejoicing.
All right. That's the right answer on this Sunday morning.
Amen. Amen.
You know, here we are in April, and you know, everybody thinks about spring cleaning, you know, just throwing out the old and bringing in the new and organization and getting things together. I mean, this is a great time for that, isn't it?
It is. It's an awesome time for it. One of the tips that I do have that I run into all the time is carpet cleaning. A lot of times when we're cleaning our carpets at home, we tend to want the whole carpet cleaned. But the high traffic areas should be cleaned more often than the whole carpet. And we don't do that. We tend to clean the whole carpet. And what it does is it leaves the high traffic areas more a different tone than the areas that our furniture is covering. So what we should do is clean the high traffic areas more frequently than we do the whole carpet. So say, for instance, I want my carpets cleaned for spring cleaning. Well, before spring cleaning come, just clean the traffic areas so that you don't have the great high and lows in the tones of the carpet. And what that does is by the time you come for spring cleaning once a year, the carpet is toned. It's evenly toned because you've maintained the high traffic areas more frequently. Because if you look at it, if you clean the high traffic areas once at the same time that you clean the low area traffic, then you're going to see the difference in the colorization.
Indeed. You know, I never thought of that. And I believe right now people are trying, they're trying to figure out, well, what am I going to do? You know, we've got we've just come out of Easter, but we're getting ready for Mother's Day. People are preparing different family gatherings and things. And so now is the time to really be thinking about your spring cleaning.
Definitely. And there's also another tip tip that I would suggest is for the window cleaning. A lot of times we want to clean our windows when it's bright outside and you can actually see the smudges. But when you clean it on cloudy days, you get a better clean because the sun doesn't dry it as fast.
What you say?
Now. And it leaves streaks when it dries faster because you don't have enough time to get the suds off.
Right.
So that's why you get the streaks.
See, that's why you're an expert at this. So you've touched on a couple things. Tell us, in general, all of the services that Williams International provides.
Well, we do commercial cleaning, of course, general cleaning, cleaning carpets. We also do floor care, and we also do home cleaning. We do one-time cleaning for commercial and residential, and we also do scheduled clients. So if you want to become a client and you want once a week cleaning for your residential home, we can do that as well as commercial.
You know, I'm glad you said that on residential cleaning because I want to help some of the folks listening. You know, I was in a company years ago, and one of the things that they really taught was you need to have a cleaning service because when you're busy, when you're doing different things, you know, you need to have a cleaning service come in. And at that time, many of us thought, oh, you had to be, you know, extremely wealthy in order to have a cleaning service come in.
No.
But that's not true.
No.
And it's something that needs to be done to give yourself a break sometimes.
Mm-hmm. And with Williams International, we cater our services based on your need.
Mm.
So if you're not requiring a entire house clean, deep cleaning, and say, for instance, I need my stove clean, and I don't have the time to clean that. You can call us for that specific job to be done. Or if you just, my refrigerator is just wrecked, and I don't have time to get to it. I have guests coming over, and I need this clean. We will come in and do that service for you.
Wow. You're talking about customized services is really what you're saying.
Yes, definitely. Definitely.
Oh, my goodness. Now, you got folks right now saying, well, get to the phone number. Give us your contact information because that is something. You mean I don't have to have my whole house clean? You'll do, special jobs?
Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Jobs, yes.
What's your contact information?
314-323-1877.
Say that one more time.
314-323-1877.
You know, you mentioned about floor care. With so many homes now, of course, the carpet, but there are many people who have the wood flooring.
Mm-hmm.
And I see such beautiful, beautiful wood floors, but it takes something to keep that up, doesn't it?
It does.
Yeah. Tell us about that and that service that you provide.
Actually, my recommendation for wood flooring is less water. No, really no water. If you can get around cleaning your floors, your wood floors without water, that's a good thing. The less water, the longer they last. The less water, the longer they last. You should do a damp mopping. I would recommend maybe once a week. And if you could get away with not doing that and just spotting it, I would recommend that. Wood floors does not do well with a lot of water. A lot of water is not good for wood flooring. There's also some natural, green cleaners that you can get at your local hardware stores that does well on wood floors for treating them and keeping them. I will recommend that, not your everyday cleaners that you would use on ceramic or tile floors,
right?
Not on your wood.
I know many folks who will say, you know what? Well, I don't have they don't have the right stuff to use for their floor, so they just use some dish detergent or use something.
No.
And I know that can't be right.
No, it's not. And it's not a good cleaner for your floors. A lot of times there's stain on your floors, so you don't want any harsh chemicals on them to hurt the stain that's on your floor. So you want something really gentle, something that's dry to just go over the floor, dust them, but definitely not your everyday household.
Right.
No.
Could that, was that a confession? Did I just make a confession?
Yes.
No, somebody told me that. That wasn't me. And so for those who are listening who are thinking, well, I would like somebody to come in maybe on a part-time basis to do spot cleaning or to do, you know, their entire home, would you come out and give a free consultation to find out and to assess the needs?
Yes, we do give a free consultation, and we also will give a first-time discount service. If we come out and we service you for the first time and you sign up for continued services, we will discount your first service for you. And all consultations are free for the first time.
Yes. And yes. I think it's important that really you sit down with the homeowner or whoever, just to really find out what they need. Because sometimes we think we need something and we really don't need that particular service, but we need something else.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about the commercial cleaning, because we have many churches that are listening. We have organizations. Tell us your services on how that would work with a commercial building.
Well, with a commercial building, usually they have general managers or managers that has a specific budget. And what we do, just like any client, we customize our services to provide for them what their needs are. Every building and every customer's, their needs are different. So there is no set formula that we use for deciding what we provide, because everybody's different. But we do customize services for everyone. When you're talking commercial, we do have staff. They're licensed, they're bonded, and they're insured. So that gives an extra security for the, you know, for the building,
yes,
and for the
yes.
customer, so that they don't have any worries.
I want to let my listeners know that if you're just tuning in this morning, we're talking with Ms. Veronica Williams of Williams International Incorporated, doing business as Essentially Clean. You know, one of the things I love when you walk into your house or someplace and you just clean, I love the smell of bleach. I tell you, I love the smell of bleach. Now, I know bleach is not applicable in every situation.
No, it isn't.
But I love, when I was saying the name of the business, Clean, you know, you want, when you walk into one of your offices that you have just finished doing, or when you walked into the home, I mean, it ought to be spotless. You ought to just clean, essentially clean. I mean, I love that. How did you get the name?
God.
Oh, back to God. That's right.
Just God.
Now, tell us about, because you mentioned, you know, of course, we talked about the churches, but is there a certain area? I mean, are St. Louis County, Illinois? Tell us the areas that you service.
We service Illinois, the metropolitan area. We also service St. Peter, St. Charles, Wentzville. Those are the main areas that we do service.
So you're almost everywhere.
Yeah.
Almost everywhere.
Yes.
I know I've asked you about the commercial cleaning, of course, and all of that. But, you know, tell me about daycares. You know, daycares are really, I mean, all of them, of course, but daycares are really important. You're cleaning for our little people, for the infants, for the toddlers, for children. And so that takes special attention as well. Can you go into daycares, give them information, kind of really do a checklist on maybe what, you know, what they could do even more?
We can, and especially with sanitation, making sure that the things that they touch in their area is sanitized and free from germs. A lot of times we look at high up because we're high up, but when you go into those places, you need to get into the area of their eye scope and clean those areas and make sure that those areas are free from debris and free from dirt.
Yes.
And sanitized.
Yes. Because I think that would be wonderful to go into the daycares, to go into locations, just to kind of really give them a checklist on, well, you know, this area, that area. Because to the untrained eye, you might miss some things, but this is what you do. You're a professional at this.
Yes, I am. And it is important. a lot of times people, they will say, well, I'll just hire someone to do it.
Right.
But when you specialize in that, your eye is trained to see things that you wouldn't normally see or consider a hazard.
Yes.
Or even consider to need cleaning.
Yes. It,
you know, you could look at a surface and say, well, it looked clean,
right,
but it's full of germs.
Oh, my.
You know, it's really full of germs.
Yes.
And we use a lot of green chemicals so mm-hmm. that it's safe for children, because children, they touch things.
Right.
They put their mouth on things.
Right, right.
You know, they drop things and pick them up and put them back in their mouths. So it's good to have chemicals that things you clean with that are not harmful for
yes,
them.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, in well, the environment.
I tell you, I'm excited about it. You make me not want to clean my house, and that you come and do it, all right?
Amen, amen. We
so
will do that.
You will do that. So I want to let our listeners know once again that we're talking this morning with Ms. Veronica Williams of Williams International Incorporated, doing business as Essentially Clean. Now, give us your contact information again as we get ready to close.
The contact number is 314-323-1877. Again, 314-323-1877.
And we will also have information about Essentially Clean on the CBCRadioshow.com website. Well, I'm excited. Thank you so much for being a part of the program today. Is there anything else that you'd like to say this morning?
No, I'm happy that you invited me to come.
To God be the glory. Thank you so much for being a part of the program.
Amen.
All right, friends, we're going to take a short break right here. I'm going to start getting my list together on the stuff that needs to be clean. How about you? Friends, thank you for listening to the CBC Radio Show this morning. Go to the website, thecbcradioshow.com. To God be the glory.
Christian Business Connection. Connecting your business or ministry to the world.